In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, Lord God, we cannot thank you enough for all the graces and the blessings. Lord Jesus, we believe that you want us to do your works and do it in such a power that the enemy will go and scamper away because of your presence and your love and your power that you are pouring out upon us. And I ask you, Lord God, to forgive us of all our sins. Have mercy on us, O Lord. And let your presence, the presence that brings forth healings and deliverance and miracles will be upon us for your greater glory and honor. And Lord, in your name, O Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, by the power of his blood, his cross, and his resurrection, we take authority over all curses, hexes, spells, voodoo practices, witchcraft assignments, satanic rituals, incantations, and evil wishes that have been sent our way or have passed down the generational bloodline. We break all forms of demonic oppression and influence over our life and over this international prayer meeting, Lord, and by the power of the risen Lord Jesus Christ, we ask that all curses be replaced with choicest blessings, anointing and power, O Lord, and your presence, your mighty presence. We ask, Lord, for forgiveness for and denounce all negative inner vows and agreements that we have made with the enemy. And we ask that you, Lord Jesus Christ, release us from any bondage that they may have held in us. We claim your shed blood over all aspects of our lives and all aspects of this international prayer meeting. We also ask you, Lord, that your precious blood be upon all our relationships, ministry endeavors, and finances. We thank you, Lord, for your enduring love, your angelic protection, St. Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael, and all the archangels and angels in heaven, and Lord, and for the fullness of your abundant blessings, for the fullness of the choicest blessings that you are pouring out upon us. We ask this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And amen. And amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for loving us. We thank you for sending your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to the world to save and to set us free. We trust in your power and grace that sustains and restores us. Loving Father, touch us now with your healing hands, for we believe that your will is for us to be well in mind, body, soul, and spirit. Cover us with the most precious blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, from the top of our heads to the soles of our feet. Cast out anything that should not be in us. Root out any unhealthy and abnormal cells. Open any blocked arteries or veins and rebuild and replenish any damaged areas. Remove all inflammation and cleanse any infection by the power of Jesus' precious blood. Let the fire of your healing love pass through our entire bodies to heal and make new any diseased areas so that our bodies will function the way you created them to function. Touch also our minds and our emotions, even into the deepest recesses of our hearts. Heal the hurts and pains and all the wounds that we have in our lives. Saturate our entire beings with your presence, love, joy, and peace, and draw us ever closer to you every moment of our lives. And Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit and empower us to do your works so that our lives will bring glory and honor to your holy name. We ask this in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Father, by the blood of Jesus, deliver us and our family members and all our relatives and friends from the dreaded COVID-19 and from all pestilences and pandemics of all kinds, shapes, or forms in the mighty name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, save us and all our relatives and friends from serious illnesses and accidents, disasters, natural and man-made, and from the terror of demons and all attacks of the evil one, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, by the blood of Jesus, let every physical and spiritual burden on our shoulders be lifted now, in Jesus' name. Lord, we send the Spirit and the blood of Jesus into every spiritual realm of wickedness where our lives are being discussed and manipulated. Let the blood scatter them in Jesus' name. Father, we plead the blood of Jesus over our homes. Let it put a bloodline protection round about our homes in Jesus' name. Father, just as the blood of the Passover shielded Israelites from destruction in Egypt, let the blood of Jesus Christ shield us and my loved ones and all our friends from all forms of destruction. Father, let the Spirit and the blood of Jesus arise now and fight the battle for us in the name of Jesus. Father, let the blood of Jesus destroy every power assigned to follow us in order to hinder our progress in the name of Jesus. Father, where blood has been shed in order to bring a negative covenant into effect in our lives and with our families and with our friends, let the blood of Jesus neutralize it and break it now in Jesus' name. Blood of Jesus, deliver us by fire in the name of Jesus. We command all our blessings confiscated by rulers of darkness to be released and to be poured out upon us in the name of Jesus. We cut ourselves off from every territorial spirit and from the spirits in the atmosphere, in the air, in the water, and in the fire, in the mighty name of Jesus. We command all demonic entities installed to hinder our progress to be roasted and to reverse gears in the name of Jesus.
Lord Jesus, bear all our physical and spiritual burdens now in the name of Jesus. Every power stealing our virtues, die in the name of Jesus. Every power in the heavenlies, on earth and in the seas, hindering the angels of our blessings, die in the name of Jesus. Any power diverting the blessings of God away from us, your time is up. Die now in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, every owner of evil load, carry your load in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, pursue our evil and demonic pursuers in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, arise and fight our battles in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, pursue poverty out of our lives in the name of Jesus. Every power assigned to follow us, to destroy us, die in the name of Jesus. Every power that aims to inflict harm and destruction to our family members and all our relations and friends, die in the name and by the blood of Jesus. Every entity and every power that molests and causes division and recriminations and illnesses and afflictions with us and our family members, die in Jesus' name and by the precious blood of Jesus. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, we claim victory and healing, wholeness and peace and miracles unto our lives and unto all our friends and relations. Amen.
To you, O blessed Joseph, do we come in our afflictions, and having implored the help of your most holy spouse, we confidently invoke your patronage also. Through the charity which bound you to the Immaculate Virgin Mother of God, and through the paternal love with which you embraced the child Jesus, we humbly beg you, graciously, to regard the inheritance which Jesus Christ has purchased by his blood and with your power and strength to aid us in our necessities. O most watchful guardian of the Holy Family, defend the chosen children of Jesus Christ. O most loving Father, ward off from every contagion of error and corruption, influence. O our most mighty protector, be kind to us, and from heaven assist us in all our struggle with the power of darkness. As once you rescued the child Jesus from the deadly peril, so now protect God's holy church from the snares of the enemy and from all adversity. Shield too each one of us by your constant protection, so that supported by your example and your aid, we may be able to live piously, to die in holiness, and to obtain eternal happiness in heaven. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For an increase in faith, hope, charity, and love, we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. First joyful mystery is the Annunciation, and the spiritual fruit is humility. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And Tricia and Nilo.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Nilo.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph,
love you, save souls.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us, O Holy Mother, who have recourse today.
The second joyful mystery is the Visitation. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and cried out in a loud voice, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. The moment your greeting sounded in my ears, the babe in my womb leapt for joy. The spiritual fruit, love of neighbor. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Melly and Emma.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners
now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy.
O Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we love you, save souls. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us of recourse to thee. Come, Holy Spirit, by means of the most powerful intercession of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, your most beloved spouse, Our Lady, Queen of Peace, pray for us of recourse to thee. Saint Joseph, pray for us.
The third joyful mystery is the birth of Jesus. And it came to pass while they were there that the days for Mary to be delivered were fulfilled. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. The spiritual fruit is poverty of spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Del and Ramon.
Del?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Sis?
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Excuse me.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at
death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Oh my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those most need of thy mercy. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we love you, save souls. Oh Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. Come, Holy Spirit, come, by means of the most powerful intercession of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, your most beloved spouse.
Excuse me, before we go on to the fourth mystery, I'd like to tell Sister Dale the vision is for. Maybe you have two devices there.
Maybe I know, I cannot turn off my iPad.
Yeah, because there is an echo.
Yeah, there's
so thank you. No. Yeah, thank you very much, Sister Dale. Okay, let's proceed to the fourth mystery, Jim and Erin.
The fourth joyful mystery is the presentation. When the days of her purification were fulfilled, they took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Simeon blessed them and said to his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and for the rise of many in Israel, and for a sign that shall be contradicted, and thine own soul a sword shall pierce. The spiritual fruit is purity of mind and body. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, Pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead souls to heaven, especially those most need of thy mercy. Amen.
The fifth joyful mystery, the finding of Jesus in the temple. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And he returned with his parents to Nazareth and was obedient to them. Spiritual fruit is obedience. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Lou and Emmeline. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Our Father, it was supposed to be in Latin.
Lou, Sister Lou.
Pater Noster, Deus in Cielos, Sanctificitor, Nomen Tuum, Adveniat Regnum Tuum, Fiat Voluntas Tua, Sicut in Cielo et in Terra, Panem Nostrum Quotidianum da Nobis Hodie, et Demite Nobis Debita Nostra, Sicut et Nos Demitimus Debitoribus Nostris, et ne nos Inducas in Tentationem, sed Libera Nos Amalo. Amen.
Salve Maria, Puno Rahmat, Tuhan bersertamu, terpujilah engkau di antara wanita dan terpujilah buahmu, tubuhmu, Yesus. Santa Maria, Bunda Allah, doakanlah kami yang berdosa ini, sekarang dan waktu kami mati. Amin.
Now, Cantonese, we have Andy and Ada. Are they here? Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In Cebuano, we have Michelle.
Magimaya ka Maria, napuno ka grasya, ang Panginoon na ito sinaka ni mo, ulan ikaw sa babaeng kanan. O bulanes sa bunga sa sanggi ni Jesus. Santa Maria, minahal kay Diyos, iampo kami ni sala. Nawan kami sa matay. Amen.
Friends, Linda.
Je vous salue, Marie, pleine de grâce. Le Seigneur est avec vous. Vous êtes bénie entre toutes les femmes. Jésus, le fruit de vos entrailles. et béni. Sainte Marie, Mère de Dieu, priez pour nous, pauvres pécheurs, maintenant et à l'heure de notre mort. Amen.
In English, Desi.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
German, Sister Dale. Sister Dale, German.
Oh, sorry. Gegrüßet seist du, Maria. I cannot turn off my iPad.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Gegrüßet seist du, Maria, voll der Gnade. Der Herr ist mit dir. Du bist gebenedeit unter den Frauen. Und gebenedeit ist der Frucht deines Leibes, Jesus. Heilige Maria, Mutter Gottes, bitte für uns Sünder, jetzt und eine Stunde unseres Todes. Amen.
In Ilocano, we have Sister Delia.
Ave Maria, napnuka ti gracia, niapo Diyos ti adaken ka, sikati na ingasatan kadagiti babae, ket na ingasatan met ti bunga ti tiyan mo ani Jesus. Santa Maria, ngayon na ti Diyos, ikakaasin na kami ang managbasol. Itakit inton oras, ipapatay mi. Amen.
We have Spanish, Elsa. Elsa.
Dios te salve, María. Llena eres de gracia. El Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén.
We have a Tagalog, Chen.
Aba, Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasayo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat, at pinagpala rin naman ang anak mong si Jesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan, ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen.
We have Mong, we have Bangtu.
Kanya kalu malia tu to jian ji bu xia. Ho tan du ne kanya ka to gong dong hong cha yi zhen zhong ba ni di shi. Tie ye su lu ji yo ka lu jie ji to gong dong hong. Leng qian malia chen du leng ni ka tan du lu bei jian neng cao. Ni nao mo zao to bei lu jie duo. Amen.
Amen. So the Latin glory be will be recited by Sister Lou.
Gloria Patri, et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc, et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Salve Regina, in Latin, will be sung by Dr. Dodong.
Salve Regina. Mater misericordiae,
vita dulcedo, et spes nostra salve, a tui clamamus, ex solis filii heavi, a te suspiramus, hementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vali. Ia ergo advocata nostra, illus tuus misericordes oculos ad nos converti. Et Jesu, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilio ostendi. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis Virgo Maria.
Thank you, Annabelle and Dr. Dodong. So we will have the memorare.
Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, a virgin of virgins, my mother. To thee do I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O mother of the word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy, hear and answer me.
Amen.
You expired, Jesus, but the source of life gushed forth for souls, and the ocean of mercy opened up for the whole world. O fount of life, unfathomable divine mercy, envelop the whole world and empty yourself out upon us. O blood and water, which gush forth from the heart of Jesus as a fountain of mercy for us, I trust in you. O blood and water, which gush forth from the heart of Jesus as a fountain of mercy for us, I trust in you. O blood and water, which gush forth from the heart of Jesus as a fountain of mercy for us, I trust in you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. For Mary shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Mally and Emma.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for
and those of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful
passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Del and Ramon.
Del. Eternal Father, I offer you the precious body, blood, soul, and divinity, our dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
and mercy on us in the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion. Brother Bob, just continue it, please. I cannot turn off my iPad. Sorry.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Jim and Mary Erin for the fourth decade. Eternal Father,
Eternal Father, we offer you the body, blood, soul, and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Now the fifth will be, the fifth mystery will be sung by John and also GR, RJ. Are they here? Madre, John and RJ.
Mercy.
Eternal God, in whom mercy is endless and the treasury of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we might not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy in itself. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Thank you, Mary Erin, for leading the rosary and the chaplet for the Divine Mercy. And once again, I thank everyone who said the individual prayers and those who said the rosaries in the chaplet of the Divine Mercy. We cannot thank you enough for serving the Lord and by serving God's people. And also, I thank all the hosts and co-hosts, as Comadre Vicky and other co-hosts. We thank you for your services, for the Lord's glory and honor. and of course the music ministry. You know, you just heard the song that was sung by RJ and also by John. And we are proud of you. Thank you for your services. Like RJ is 11 years old, but thank God he has been serving the Lord through his songs, through his prayers. And I just pray that we have more kids, more young people like RJ, who in their young age has been serving the Lord, and may your tribe multiply, okay? And all the members of the music ministry, I thank you in advance for your saying yes to the Lord, because the Lord is good to us. And also, we are going into praise and worship, the very important, one of the most important segments of this prayer meeting is to praise and worship the Lord. And actually, it's the main reason why we are here, is to praise his glory. So sing, even though you are muted, but sing to the Lord from all your heart, from all your mind, from all your being. Give glory to him, because, you know, he's worthy to be praised. And by the way, RG is not 11 years old. He's only 8 years old. He's only 8 years old. And he's already serving the Lord. Praise God. And he has been doing it since, you know, even younger. You know, when he was 5 years old, he's been praying, right, John? He's been in the rosary, yeah.
Yes, Bob, yes.
So we are really proud of him, okay? So as I said, now we are going into praise and worship, which is the heart and the heart and the purpose, the main purpose of our prayer meeting, to praise his glory. So I would like you to sing with us, even though you are muted, just sing from your heart. Now we will project the words of the songs. And after we sing, we pause for, we pray in tongues, we worship the Lord in our own dialect or in our own, so if we have the gift of tongues, worship him and praise him with the gift of tongues. Worship him in your own dialect. No, you are welcome to do that. Okay, so, and if the Lord is giving you words or prophecy or knowledge, or is prompting you to read the passage in the scripture, please obey him, because obedience is better than sacrifice. Obedience to the Lord is the gateway to experiencing his presence and his love and his power. So anyway, and also before we go on, I also would like to remind the members of the core group and the music ministry that we will have a meeting on Tuesday at 5 p.m. Pacific time, which is 8 p.m. East Coast time and 8 a.m. Philippine time, okay? And also we'll talk about the agenda of our prayer meeting next Saturday. So please attend this important core meeting and music ministry meeting on Tuesday, 8, as I repeat, 5 p.m. California time or Pacific Daylight Time, and or 8 p.m. East Coast time or 8 a.m. Philippine time. And now we will call on our music ministry to start praising the Lord, start worshiping the Lord in songs. So I'd like to call on our sister Janie to sing that our theme song, We Are the Children of God.
Thank you.
Please continue to mute yourselves. Praise you, Lord. Unmute yourselves. We praise you, Lord. We glorify your name. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, God. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord in your own language, in your own dialect. Praise him in using the gift of the Holy Spirit. Praise you.
Praise the Lord.
We glorify your name. You are the Most High and the Holy One. You are the Alpha and the Omega. Please unmute yourselves. Ambariasi andari. Glory to your
Father. Purihin ka ngayon, magpakailan mo. Lord, we are Lord. We praise you. We glorify you. We give you. We give you thanks, O Lord.
Thank you, God, for all you've given us. Thank you.
We praise you, we glorify you, hallelujah. Hallelujah, you are so good, oh Lord. God is good all the time. God is good. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for healing us. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you. We trust in you, Lord. We praise you, we glorify you, Abba, 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 Abba.
God the Father, we praise God the Son, we praise God the Holy Spirit. Spirit, we praise you.
Thank you, Lord. We praise you. We glorify you. Thank you, Lord, for all the
glory, all honor,
of the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
All power, all majesty, all thanksgiving are yours, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, and forever. Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for your protection, for your guidance.
Lord,
Lord, for your guidance in Jesus Christ.
The Lord is saying to us, my children, I want you to repent all your sins. Repent, my children, and come back to me. Refrain from doing evil works and evil thoughts and evil deeds. Come to me, my children, because the time of refreshing is coming, and it's already here. The time of refreshing is coming from me, the Lord your God. Come to me, my people. Come to me. I'm asking you to refrain from doing evil and from hurting one another.
Amen. Please, Lord.
Come to me, my children, because the time of refreshing is here and is coming. Know my people, that I have plans for you. I have great plans for you. And do not block those plans that I have for you by turning your back on me. I want you to repent of all your sins and come back to me. Come back to me, my people. Do not let the evil one allow. Do not keep him to keep on attacking you. Do not allow the enemy from taking you away from me. Know, my people, that I am equipping you. Know, my people, they are giving you the tools to defeat him. Use the tools they have given you. Continue to follow me. Continue to put me into your heart. Walk with me, my people. I want you, my people, to remain faithful to me, my people, and to follow my words, and to keep my words in your heart. I love you, my people, says the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the Lord is also saying in the book of 2 Peter, chapter 3, verse 9, the Lord is not slow in keeping his promise, as some understand slowness. He is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So we'll continue to sing to the Lord. As I said, just listen to your heart, because the Lord speaks into your heart, our heart. Listen to his voice. So we'll continue to sing to the Lord. I'd like Jenny to sing Our God.
Okay, thank you.
Our God, please sing that song.
Okay, please mute.
Yes, unmute yourselves. And after Chini sings, we'll unmute ourselves and we praise the Lord in song, in our words, our own words, words from our heart, our vernacular or our own dialects, or in English or in tongues. Amen. Our God is greater.
Okay, thank you.
Romans 8:31. God is for us, who can be against us? Water you turned into wine, open the eyes of the blind, there's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of these ashes we rise, there's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. Into the darkness we shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. And if our God is with us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is for us, what could stand against? And if our God is with us, and who could ever stop us? And if our God is for us, what could stand against? What could stand against? Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. And if our God is with us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is for us, what could stand against? And if our God is with us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, what could stand against? What could stand against? Jeremiah 10:6, there's no one like you. Unmute.
Unmute yourself, Ham Bariyashi and Bari. We praise you, Lord. We glorify you.
First, for the name of Jesus Christ, now and forever. First, for the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, now and forever. First, for the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, we glorify your name. Glory to God, No one like you, God. You are light of salvation.
Thank you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. The God being the glory. The God being the glory. The Lord is worthy. 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 The Lord is will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. Then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land, says the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Continue to forgive us of all our sins and heal our lands, O Lord.
Amen.
Heal all these trials and tribulations and attacks from the enemy, O Lord. Lord, we know that you are with us. And Lord, we know that as we turn our evil ways, we turn our wicked ways, you are there to forgive us. You are there to welcome us, O Lord, like we are prodigal sons, Lord, and like the father of the prodigal son, the prodigal children, and we are the prodigal children. And as we come back to you, Lord, we know that even before we come back to you, are there with open arms to welcome us back, and to heal us and to wipe away our tears. We praise you.
Yes, Lord.
Glorify your name. Hallelujah, Lord. Glory to your holy name. And Lord, we call out to you. Lord, we give to you all our hearts, all our mind, our spirit. Do unto us as you will, O Lord, because you are the God who loves us. You are the God who wants what is best for us. We praise you, Lord. So, Lord, we give you all our heart, Lord. And, Lord, as we ask Dr. Dodong to sing the song, Lord, I give you our heart. Lord, as Dr. Dodong sings the song, we ask you to change our stony heart into heart of flesh, O Lord. Turn our stony hearts, our hardened hearts, into hearts of flesh. Thank you, Lord. Dr. Dodong, sing the song. Please.
This is my desire to honor you, Lord, with all my heart, I worship you. All I have within me, I give you praise.
in you.
Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. This is my desire, to honor you. Lord, with all my heart, I worship you. All I have within me, I give you praise. And all that I adore is in you. Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm away. Lord, have your way in me. And I will live, and I will live for you. And I will live, and I will live for you. And I will live, and I will live for you. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm away. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm away. Lord, have your way in me. And you.
Ambari asi ambari.
Ambari asi ambari.
Ambari asi ambara.
Ambari asi
ambari. Ambari asi ambari. Ambari asi ambari. Ambari asi ambari. Ambari asi ambari.
Abba,
thanks.
Thank you. We glorify you. Here we are, Lord. If we come to do your will.
Thank you, Lord, for everything. We praise you.
We glorify you. We give you thanks.
Thank you, God, for everything.
Sanctify your name. Save the truth.
The truth and the life.
Thank you, Lord. We praise you. Thank you. Thank you for all your blessings. Thank you for all your guidance. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. We glorify you. Thank you, Lord.
Blessed be God, blessed be God, and his angels.
You know, the Lord has spoken into my heart that we have to come back to him.
Amen.
To repent of all our sins. And he led me to read to you Isaiah chapter 44, verse 22. He said, I have swept away your offenses like a cloud, your sins like the morning mist. Return to me, for I have redeemed you, says the Lord. So he wants us, it's very clear that he wants us to return to him and to repent of our sins, to cry out to him for forgiveness of our sins.
Amen.
So he, you know, it's very clear that this message today, and it's been message all the time, message calling us to repentance of all our sins, because we have committed sins. Nobody here has not committed a sin, but everybody has sinned. But the good news is that the Lord, if we only come to him and ask for forgiveness, he's always there to welcome us.
Amen.
And to forgive us of all our sins. It doesn't matter how serious our sins may be, but if we come to him asking for forgiveness, he's there to set us free and to forgive us. That's how good God is.
Amen.
That's how good God is.
Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on her. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on her. Melt her, mold her, feel her, use her. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on her. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Melt us, mold us, feel us, you. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us.
Ambariasi andari, Go ahead
and unmute everybody and praise the Lord.
Unmute and let us praise the Lord. Glory to your holy name. We praise the Lord. We glorify your name. I am the Holy One. For the Alpha and the Omega. Glory to you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
We come to do your will.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And the Lord is saying to us, especially to some of us who could not forgive yourself. There are people here. There are people among us who could not forgive themselves. You could not forgive yourselves. The Lord is saying, I want you, my people, to forgive yourselves. To forgive yourselves, because you cannot forgive others if you cannot forgive yourselves. No, my children, that I'm giving you the grace to forgive yourselves. I am here to forgive you. So do not be hard on yourselves. Forgive yourselves of your guilt. Forgive yourselves, my people, because I am here to bind up your wounds. And in the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 7, the Lord God says, let the wicked forsake his way, and the evil man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord, and he will have mercy on him, and to our God, for he will freely pardon. So he pardons us of all our sins, as long as you come back to him. So forgive yourselves also. Forgive yourselves so that the Lord can set you free, of your guilt. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise your holy name. Thank you, Lord.
We praise you.
Hold on. I sense that we will continue to praise him and to thank him. Thank him. Can you sing that song? Thank you, Lord.
I come before you today. Is there something that I want to say? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all you've given to me, for all the blessings that I cannot see. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an outstretched arm, I will bless your name. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. For all you've done in my life, you took my darkness and gave me your light. Thank you, Lord. took my sin and my shame. You took my sickness and healed all my pain. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an outstretched arm, I will bless your name. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. Hosanna to you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And the Lord also is saying, I have been led by the Lord to read to you the book of Ezekiel, chapter 18, verse 21. Ezekiel, chapter 18, verse 21. If a wicked man turns away from all the sins he has committed and keeps all my decrees and does what is just and right in my eyes, he will surely live. He will not die, says the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we praise you.
Thank you.
We believe, Lord, that you are with us, that you are there to strengthen us. And thank you, Lord, for letting us know and for your words, because your words, they are spirit and they are life. Lord, thank you for letting us know that if we come to you with repentant hearts, we will not die, but we live forever and ever and ever.
Amen.
Glory to your holy name.
Amen.
Praise you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Amen and amen and amen. So, sisters and brothers, it's very clear that the Lord wants us to come to him. You know, we have been overwhelmed by all these attacks from the enemy. We have been overwhelmed from the all the wiles of the enemy. But the thing is, sisters and brothers, we have to cling to the Lord. We have to cling to him.
Amen.
And set our hearts upon him. Focus our eyes and hearts upon him, because he is there to rescue us and to forgive us of all our sins. So we have to change our direction.
Amen.
Towards evil, towards sin.
Mm.
And we should have a metanoia.
Amen.
That means changing our heart and mind.
Amen.
And our direction and focus on the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
On the Lord. Sisters and brothers.
Mm.
So now, Comadre Vicky will gave her teachings on how to come out of our tomb of sinfulness into that the light and life, like Lazarus was raised from the dead by the Lord. Come, get out of the tomb like Lazarus. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, Comadre Vicky.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you, Compadre. And I just want to share with you, I am so honored and very honored to be here right now. The anointing, the prayer cover of the music, the empowerment of these prayers, everything is just so beautiful. And now every single song, every single word my compadre Bob just said right now is a part of my talk. This is the way the Lord works in unity to unify his people.
Amen.
This is our talk. Let's get out of the tomb like Lazarus. Our beloved Zoom meeting has brought us all together. We're called to be healed or to be vessels of God's healing, to proclaim the love of God into this world. We're called to be his light. But we notice that for some of us who've been here, there's one person and one person alone who's been here every single meeting since we first began well over a year ago, sometime in March. Cindy Schubling started us. We took it from there. And we've seen so many powerful healings, so many miracles, so many beautiful testimonies. We've seen a powerful anointing of our music. We have seen and we've fought the battles, and God is still reigning supreme in this beautiful, beloved prayer group. There are souls that he brings us, and those souls, that soul is you. And there are some issues we want to share with you so that you could be empowered to be truly 100% a child of God. So let's go on and continue. Are you doing some tomb thinking? Are you defined by life? Are you defining your life by your past? Because you're cursed to live in it, even though it's the present moment and we're working towards the future. Do you think we are defined by other people? Do we live by their life rules? Are we defined by our feelings or lack of them? Are we defined by our culture that at times is misunderstood? Are we defined by our own misguided thoughts? And are we defined by the worldview of life, or or the disrespect of it? Please, right now, let's stop defining ourselves. I mean, are we tired of living this life that limits God? How deep of a hole do we plan to keep digging? Why do we go living like this? We exist, but we're surrounded by these unhealthy, ungodly beliefs. We ask, we pray, we look around. So now what? Don't let the world define you. You are a child of God. Your value derives directly from God. As heir of Almighty God, your value, I'm talking to you, your value is beyond measure. It doesn't matter whether you're single or divorced. It doesn't matter if you're jobless or homeless. It doesn't matter if you're sick or handicapped. Don't let those things define you. Let God take over your life and step into freedom in Christ. Do you know that it is not anything or anyone around you, up in the heavenlies or down below? You and only you can break these chains that are binding you to all this unhappiness, anxiety, fear, guilt, shame, unworthiness, unforgiveness. Our Lord lovingly speaks to you today. All he says is so simple. Come follow me. And wait a minute. You don't have to go get, just all of a sudden put up roadblocks or put another bandage on your tomb feeling. All he just says, Just come as you are. Did you know that you are made in God's own image? He formed you, and I'm speaking to you. Don't close your eyes. Don't be blinded. Wake up. He formed you in your mother's womb to be who you are, and who you are meant to be has already been set in place in God's eternity. And from eternity, it was passed down into time, to the time of your birth. So I praise you, God, and I thank you. We are so blessed because we have you. We have this person. We have the person that's hearing this talk here with us today. So when you entered here, actually, your soul entered into your human body, and it was all equipped with perfect gift of life, perfectly and wonderfully made. Do you know there was no one like you? Our Lord says in Jeremiah, before I formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. So God has been waiting for this precious moment to be with you, to share with you, to love you, to again remind you that you are his child, not a child of the world, not a child of another person, not a child of your fear, not a child of any disease, not a child of anything around you. And for some of us, I'll raise my hand to that, he had been waiting so, so long, yet he's God. And in just the right time, he's gifting you this moment of love to share with him. So if you find yourself not believing this talk, you're not sensing, this is not for me. If you find yourself in any predicament, or if you find yourself not fully living God's blessing, feeling like the world's problems are on you, if you're just breathing just to exist because everything around you is so lousy, or if you're feeling like, why me, the victim mentality, if you're being plagued by illness, depression, sadness, hey, stop. Let's tackle this issue now. Where to start? Let's see. How are we going to start? You're going to start by listening. What are you going to do? What are you going to listen to? This story. When? Right now. Where? Here. Step one. Let's begin using those spiritual gifts God gave us at our conception, the full armor of God. I'll go back to this. When we get up in the morning and we change our clothes, we put on clothes. Why? To protect us, to cover us, to keep us safe, to keep us healthy. When you walk out of the door, you don't walk out of the door naked. You don't go into a terrible snowstorm in a bikini or shorts. No, you need to spiritually, especially now more than ever, I plead with you. It takes all of 5 seconds to just lift up your hands and say, Lord, I claim the armor of God on me today. Was that like 3 seconds? And you consciously might not feel the spiritual garment of protection, but your heart does, your soul does, your spirit does, and you're planting seeds of protection for you. You plant those seeds turn into blessings, not only for you, but it goes forward and removes some of those curses that are generational. So we begin by the spiritual gifts. So sometimes people, my brothers and sisters, sometimes the strongest people are those who love beyond all measure. They cry when no one can see, and they fight battles that only God knows about. So you put on that armor of God. And if you forget in the morning and sometime during the day, believe me, your guardian angel, mine's really, thinks I'm hard-headed. So she'll remind me, oh, okay. Yes, Lord, I claim you as my Lord and Savior, the armor of God that you have given me as a gift, as a protection, as a prayer cover. I'm claiming that. Boom. So be strong in the Lord. You know, we don't have to get, I mean, this is a whole week-long seminar of the armor of God. And all you have to know is that It is the armor, and it's a protective battle gear, not against children or those you love. It's a protection gear for the spiritual battle against evil. And it's the breastplate of the belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God. So are you getting this? Is it working? Let's keep going. So give us a moment. Can we share our faith with you? Okay, once upon a time, oops, wrong story. Let's go back 2,000 years ago. Our full understanding of what we're trying to do today won't be completed without the story of, would you please mute, please? Without the story of Lazarus. Can you kindly mute? Lazarus and his two sisters, Mary and Martha, were friends of Jesus. When Lazarus felt ill, his sister sent a message to Jesus, "Lord, the one you love is sick." When Jesus heard the news, he waited two more days before going to Lazarus' hometown in Bethany. Jesus knew that he would do a great miracle for God's glory, and therefore he was not in a hurry. Jesus arrived in Bethany. Lazarus was already dead and in the tomb for 4 days. When Martha discovered that Jesus was on his way, she went out to meet him. "Lord," she said, "if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Jesus told Martha, "Your brother will rise again." But Martha thought he was talking about the final resurrection of the dead. Then Jesus said these very important words, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die." When Mary met, Martha then went and told Mary that Jesus wanted to see her. Jesus had not yet entered the village, most likely to avoid the stirring up of the crowd and calling attention to himself. The town of Bethany was not far from Jerusalem, where the Jewish leaders were plotting against Jesus. When Mary met Jesus, she was grieving with strong emotion over her brother's death. The Jews who were with her were also weeping and mourning. Deeply moved by their grief, Jesus wept with them. Jesus then went to the tomb of Lazarus with Mary. Martha and the rest of the mourners. There he asked them to remove the stone that covered the hillside burial place. Jesus looked up to heaven and prayed to the Father. "Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me." When he said this, Jesus called out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Take off the grave clothes and let him go." Now let's go back to this story again. This time, let's put it into the context of our life today. If you are stuck, not living a life with God's faith, hope, and love, please allow us to walk through this together. How can we live the life that God has given us? Well, let's go back to the beginning. "Lord, your loved one is sick." That was from Martha. Excuse me. Jesus was sent a message. "This is you. Pray to God. send him a message. Yet, I do not want you to send him a message the way some of us are sending a message. I want this to be a new message of prayer. I want you to rethink how we pray, how I used to pray. Our Father who art, thy will be done. Hail Mary, glory be. Okay, God, I'm here. You know my prayers. You know what I'm going through. Okay, you know, I am sick. I'm just going to wait here because, you know, you answer me and you love me. And no, got to change that mindset. You have the Spirit of the living God inside you. You are just on automatic talk machine. And that and zero pennies will get you nowhere. We want you to change that mindset to proclaim body, mind, soul, and spirit. Send Jesus a message. Have your Spirit of God in you touch the thrones of heaven. Redirect your feelings. Instead of being a victim of prayer and using prayer as a cane or as a grave cloth in your tomb thinking, you stand in the power of the Holy Spirit. You kneel, you sit, you lay in your bed, you go prostrate on the floor, do whatever it is, wake up and just say, Lord, this is me, your child. I am here. And I am honored to be your child. I am honored and I worship you. I thank you for giving me life. I praise your holy name. I know that every breath I take is a breath you've given me. And I want you to understand that I get you now, Lord. I understand what you're saying now, Lord. I am not going to be asleep anymore. You know what, Lord? I have this circumstance around me. I have this situation around me. It's a life lesson. And I just don't know what to do. So why am I going to a book? Why am I going to friends? Why am I going online? I have your word. I have your beautiful church. And I have you. Why am I going around in circles like a dog chasing its own tail? I have you, Lord, here I am. Now, on the second part of this story, Jesus waited 2 days. Oh my word. So what's going to happen when you get this new mindset of using the power of God's love for prayer in your life? You know, it's not going to be another like mundane straight line of prayer. It's going to be a hallelujah worship, charismatic, up and down. And God, in case you can't hear me, I'll just keep saying it and saying, I love you. And this is who I am. I get you now, Lord. Your Spirit is within me. I'm kicking out all of this other junk that's around me, and I'm going to do this. But you know what might be happening is that you pray and you say, oh, well, she said to pray, but you know, it's already been like 5 hours and nothing's happened. It's already been like 5 days. It hasn't happened. It's already been like 5 months. And, you know, be like our Blessed Mother. Ponder. Ponder as you wait. In other words, just say, I am here. I believe that I'm a child of God. I know that God created me perfectly. He created me for such a situation as I'm in right now. And I am going to focus on God and not the problem. I'm going to focus on his glory and not the situation. I'm going to focus on what it is he wants me to do and not look around and not look down. I'm going to focus on him. I'm going to focus, you're going to use your power words even stronger. And this is like getting out of a black box and trying something that some of us have never tried before. But you know what? Try it. Because if you're in a situation right now, how is that form? How is that working for you? Let's try this. Let's try God. So then Jesus said, your brother will rise again. Isn't that a powerful word? Remember, God's ways are not our ways. You'll go through your ups and downs, but focus on him. And the number one thing I think that is to me is just, it's just a mind awakening, clearing of my whole mind, body, soul, and spirit, is instead of focusing on everything negative, focusing on every problem you have, you go straight to the Lord and say, God, I am so grateful. I am so thankful. I am so confident in you, Lord, that you have my situation in the palm of your hands. And remember, if there's ever a no answer is an answer, but you don't know that because God is working in through eternity and you are in time. So in his time through eternity and he comes down, he will make things right. So you continue resetting your prayer path while waiting. Then Jesus wept with him, with them, I'm sorry. So it just shows that our Lord understands and comprehends your path, your journey, your situation, your circumstances. He wants you to be healed. He wants you to be whole. He wants you to be the creation that he created you to be. And it touches his heart when we're turned away from him. So you cry, he weeps. Until you remember, it's all about your decision in your soul to change. To change and turn to Jesus. So he says, he tells him, take away the stone. And that's after he said this powerful, powerful prayer. So what we want to do is to follow the Lord, follow his words, follow his directions via the church, the sacraments, and prayers. Once you begin to restructure your inner prayer life, you will be very much a faith-forth child of God. Just look at the souls that are in this group right now. Look at Dr. D. Look at Bob. Look at Chin. Look at Mary Erin. Look at Joe Zazinski. Look at Joe Charbonneau. I mean, I could just keep on going. I'm sorry if I've left you out for you faithful, faith-forth children of God. But once you do that, he's saying right now to you, take away the stone. Then he says, Lazarus, come out. He asked them to remove the grave clothes that he was wrapped in. Now, will you come out of that tomb? Are you going to just stay there wrapped up? Stuck is what I call it. Will you take that first step into the life that God has planned for you? Will your prayer life change? Those grave clothes are for those others who are asleep or those that are not awakened to the truth of our faith in God. We can spiritually, when I say we, the Zoom International Prayer Team, we can spiritually help you unravel those old bandages because the Lord commanded the people, he commanded the people around Lazarus to remove the grave clothes. Now, what are the grave clothes? Well, you define that. You defined what's limiting you. You defined why your circumstances are not what you think the Lord has for you. You just pray and praise with confidence, with worship, with thankfulness. But the choice for you today is yours. Remember, you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of the darkness and into his wondrous light. And here are some of the beautiful Bible praise words that he has given us. I won't read them all, but he says, here, let's look at the last one. See how very much our Father loves us, for he calls us his children. And that is what we are. But the people who belong to this world don't recognize that we are God's children because they don't know him. They're still in the tomb. So he rescued us from the domain of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved son. Come, let's all of us spiritually hold hands and come into the kingdom of his beloved son. So the reason I gave this talk is about a month or so ago, I listened to this beautiful song and it touched my heart so deeply. I wanted to try to express it personally, but I think I will share this with you so that you could understand what this talk means. So I'm going to go ahead and start it right now.
In the dark and all alone, growing comfortable. Are you too scared to move and walk out of this tomb? Buried underneath the lies that you believed. Safe and sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. Your choice to sleep, and this time to leave. Come on,
hallelujah. Amen. One more thing.
Awesome. Amen.
One more thing. I'll make it short. Remember, my beautiful brothers and sisters, when the root is deep, there's no reason to fear the storm. You will bend. You will sway.
you will move. But if Christ is at the center core of who you are, amen. The fruit that you can see is always a result of the root that you cannot see. So you know what's going to happen? I want us all to start rising up, get out of the tomb, because God's got gifts for you. And you have them already. You just need to open the present. He'll give you wisdom, understanding, counsel, fortitude, knowledge, piety, and the fear of offending the Lord. And when you do, you will see a transformation. You'll have more self-control. You'll be gentle, joy, and you'll have joy, patience, peace, kindness, faithfulness, love, goodness, and peace. All brought to you by the Holy Spirit from up above, but that Holy Spirit power living inside of you. Today, I just want to thank God for the gift of life. No complaints, no requests. Just be thankful. My brothers and sisters, you are a master priest. You are handpicked by God. Thank goodness. And you are loved. You are a person of extreme value and significance. I have loved you with an everlasting love, says the Lord. And my bottom, this last phrase, when God is all you have, then you have all you need. May you be blessed by your abundance. And please, please remember the great power behind, within, around, and for you. Be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you, Madre.
Awesome, Vicky. Thank you.
Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, we took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. Of the world by darkness lay, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I stand. No power of hell, of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he returns and calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I stand.
I would like to ask some of you, if possible, most of you who have testimonies of God's healing grace, of what the Lord has done for you. And, you know, for instance, you had a problem, you have a sickness or anything, and then you know, we prayed for you, or you asked your friends to pray for you, or us here in the group, and you have a testimony, the Lord has answered prayers. This is for his greater glory and honor. Okay, who likes to be the first one to give a praise report? Because praise reports are very important, because
Carmel has one.
This doesn't only give glory to the Lord, but it increases the praise reports increase our faith in the saving and loving and healing touch of the Lord. Who has who's raising hands?
Carmel has one, or Carmel.
Carmel. Yeah, that's as I said, Carmel is the daughter of our brother Ramon and the sister of our beloved Jerry.
Praise God.
Good morning, everybody. Can you hear me?
Yes, Carmel, we can hear you.
Hi. So I was blessed enough to have been prayed over by Tito Bob and my father maybe two times. And I sent an email, and if it's okay with you guys, I'll read it out to share with you my story and my testimony. So this is my email. Thank you so much for your prayers and using your gifts for help to help me with my health issues. The biopsy results for my left breast turned out benign. After you and my father, Ramon, prayed over me via Zoom on July 30, 2021. The prayers not only helped with my healthy outcome, but the act of being prayed over also comforted me when I was very scared. Thank you for your service and acting as an instrument for the Master Healer. In the midst of these very uncertain and scary times, these reminders to come back to prayer and trust in God have been invaluable. Salamat po. May God bless all of you with continued health and happiness. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Carmel.
God,
and can you send me an email of that testimony?
Opo. Send Salamat. Na.
Yes. You have Ramon has, of course, my email address. So thank you. Thank you, Carmel. A pleasure knowing you, praying with you. And we will continue to pray for you. Continue to pray for you.
Thank you so much. And since actually I sent this email last week, more blessings have been pouring in. I lost my job during COVID, and now I have a part-time job. So, you know, God and his love is just manifesting in my life continuously. And I so much, very much thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Beautiful.
Yeah, you're welcome. Because the Lord answers our prayers. The Lord answers prayers. So if you could add to your testimony also the fact that you got this job. So, you know, and you know, the Lord is not done yet. He's not done blessing you. Amen. There are more to come. So passing your seatbelts.
And I too just want to welcome you so much. This is just part of a testimony from the talk about coming out of the grave and into his wondrous light. I do want to tell you, my compadre, that I am not the host of this prayer meeting. I have not touched the PowerPoint except for my talk. Your dad, Ramon, is doing an excellent job being the host.
Yeah,
we have our spiritual daughter, Cherry, your sister here. And now Carmel is here. Compadre, do you not see the miraculous work of the Lord?
I see it. I see it loud and clear.
His family, but he's blessing us.
Yeah.
a double fold, triple fold. We can never outdo our Lord's compassion for mercy and grace. So, wow, I'm so thankful to you, Carmel, to our beloved child, Cherry. Well, she's not a child, but she's ours. And to your dad,
Yes, and Ramon is always has been here for a long time, you know. And I think ever since we started, Comadre, having Zoom prayer meeting, you know, immediately after we started, you know, your dad joined us, and he's still here, and praise God, and Jerry also, praise the Lord. And now you know, so.
Yeah.
Praise God.
God doesn't have a sense of humor. He means it, okay?
Yeah. So please, I'm looking forward to that email with additional blessings, okay? So praise God. Thank you.
Thank you,
Carmel. Okay, anybody else would like to give a testimony, a praise report? Anybody else? Raise your hand. Have you seen anyone, Comadre?
No, I don't see anyone. I don't even see hands moving up and down. I don't.
Really? I mean, there should be a lot of us who have been touched and healed by the Lord, giving places, graces and blessings by the Lord. Okay.
Oh, there's Terry.
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 Okay,
Terry.
Hi, Terry. Unmute, Terry. Please.
Good morning.
Thank you, Terry.
Oh, thank you, brother. When I called you last week for praying for me, because it was so, my body was so tight and my legs is so stiff, and I almost cry when I called you, because I can't stand the tightness of my body because of the one that I'm complaining, where my doctor, pain doctor, injected me on my left left leg. And so after you prayed me, after 15 minutes, and then I was so blessed that it was gone, and I can sleep good on that night. And when you told, and also asked you to pray for the curse that my husband's sister-in-law, and I prayed for her, and then that one is it helps, brother. Problem.
Okay, praise God. So
thank you so much, brother.
Yeah, you're almost crying when you called me.
Yes, brother.
Your body was
my body aching. So very like tight
and aching.
That night. Yeah, and that night, and it was 10 o'clock already when I called you, brother.
So I was half asleep. You know, one eye open and one eye closed.
Thank you so much for that. When you answered me that, yeah, when I called you.
So you at that night you slept like a baby.
Oh yes, brother, until 4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh really? You slept like a baby. You know why? Because hopefully you did not, like, when you sleep like a baby, it means like every 5 minutes you wake up, you know. Sleeping like a baby now.
And also, I thank God also yesterday, brother, when I went to, I have appointment for my eye checkup.
Yeah.
And called for the insurance to give me a ride, but they misunderstand that they didn't give me a ride for my appointment. And I drove by myself because I don't want to miss that appointment. So I drove over there to Dr. Saiter. And when I went home yesterday, they hit and run my car. And the left was this one panel on top of my left, on top of the front wheel, there's a dent and already, and the guy, he hit and run, and I didn't even get the plate number because.
Oh my gosh, are you okay though? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm glad the brother is not on my door, but it's on the left panel.
On the passenger.
The passenger, right. So there's a dent in there, and even almost.
Nobody saw it.
Nobody.
A witness. Okay. Yeah.
He tried to overtake me, and then it's like bang. So I was it's close to my where I live now.
Oh my gosh!
That's your heart.
So I'm glad you are okay because I heard in the news in the radio that someone was driving on the wrong side of the road. So that was not you, huh?
No, brother. Yeah.
Okay.
It was on my left side, and then it hit the left panel of my car. Ah,
yeah, because one time there was a heavy traffic in Sacramento, and it was the traffic was put on a standstill, and then this guy says, "Oh, my mom is driving in Sacramento," So he called his mom. He said, "Mom, are you okay?" He said, "Yeah, I am okay." He said that, "I don't know." He says, "A lot of cars are driving on the opposite way."
Oh.
And there's a long line of cars. He said, "Mom," the son says, "Mom, I heard that somebody is driving on the wrong side of the freeway."
Yeah.
So anyway,
we're glad you're okay, Terry. God bless you, and even remove trauma.
Yeah, glad you're okay.
Yeah, I'm glad it didn't hit the door of my car. It's on the front part of my. So.
Wow. So you have insurance.
Yeah, I have, but it's only on liability because my car is I don't know what's gonna. How much it's gonna cost me now, that one to
Anyway, at least you're safe. You did not get injured. That's the most important thing. The most important thing.
That's why I thank God for that, brother.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Bob has a testimony.
Who else has testimony? Selena. Selena. Show yourself, Selena. Show your beautiful self.
There she is.
Okay, Selena.
Oh, can you see me now? Sorry.
Yes, we can see your beautiful self.
Okay. I do have one testimony I just thought of. It was just someone I randomly met. And I kind of thought this was neat because I had to call my cousin and kind of made him feel better because he said it's nice. He likes to hear miracles too, because it gives you that uplift about the Lord. I went last week to Rite Aid because I just needed to buy a thermometer because, I'm a pharmacist and a mom. So my husband got on me because I tend to, use my hands to tell my kids how to temperature. And he says, "You need to go get a thermometer." So I went and got a thermometer to do the right thing. And so when it went in there, I was wearing a shirt and it has the Virgin Guadalupe on it. And when I went to the register, the lady at the register, she kept on looking at my shirt and she asked me, she goes, "Where did you get that shirt?" And I'm the type, I don't really talk when I don't know someone. And I just like, "Oh, I got online." And she kept on looking at it and she goes, I like your shirt. I want to know where you got it. I was like, "Oh," I go, "Well, I could show you where I got it." And I start telling, she said, "Can I tell you a story?" And I just thought it was kind of like different because, she doesn't really know me. I said, "Yes, go ahead." And she said, I didn't grow up religious. I'm not really religious or anything. But she said, when I was in Texas, she said, I had a heart attack and I was in a hospital in Texas. And she said at night, there was this man who was dressed all in white. She thought he was a male nurse, all in white. And he kept on taking care of her at night and he'll bring her blankets he was just constantly going around her, making sure she was better, and he even prayed over her. And she said the next day she asked the nurse, the female nurse, who was that male nurse, because he was so nice and he took care of her the whole time that night. And the female nurse says, I don't know who you're talking about. We don't have no male nurses here. And she goes, no, there was a male nurse who took care of me at night. And she said that they told her there is no male nurse at night that works. So she didn't really know what happened. But again, she was telling me she wasn't religious. She grew up, I guess, in the Philippines. She's half Filipino, half Portuguese. But she doesn't know anything about the Virgin Guadalupe. And she said, because she was in Texas, someone showed her the Virgin Guadalupe, and then she saw this man next to it, Juan Diego. And she asked, who's that guy? And she recognized him right away. She said, that's Juan Diego. And she said, that's the male nurse who helped me at night. And she said, I've never had anything like this happen to me, but she said, I recognized him. And when she looked at the shirt I was wearing, it had Juan Diego on the side, all in white. And she said, it's exactly what he was wearing. It was all white, his outfit. And she said, that's who, you know, was helping me. And she said, it's just, she was so, she said, ever since then, she wants to know more about the Virgin Guadalupe because she wasn't raised, I guess, in the Philippines, knowing more. She said they prayed the rosary, but it wasn't towards the Guadalupe. And she never knew about Juan Diego. So I told her, I go, well, I have stuff at home if you want. So I have this very beautiful shawl. I bought it online. And at the end of the shawl, it has the Virgin Guadalupe with Juan Diego on the side. So I went back to Rite Aid and I gave it to her. And she loved it. She said, oh, you know, I don't really wear that much. And I felt like, you know, someone who really, you could tell she really loves the Virgin Guadalupe because she couldn't stop looking at my shirt. And, you know, just the way she told the story, I just figured, let me give her that because she'll appreciate more than what I really, I don't wear as much and stuff. But I thought that was a pretty good story that she told me, and it surprised me.
It was. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that story.
Amen. That's beautiful, Zerlina.
Yeah, thank you for sharing that story with us. And it happens. You know, saints, angels will appear.
Isn't that incredible? Juan Diego was helping her in her room. I believe it.
Yes, yes. Yeah,
I was very surprised too.
Yeah. But anyway, thank you for sharing that with us. And by the way, Charlene, I've been waiting for that testimony that you promised to send us.
You're in trouble.
I'm almost done with this PowerPoint. I've been working all day on my PowerPoint. Sorry. My whole house was sick with COVID for a week. Yeah. And then day 7, I got sick with COVID for a week. So right now, I have to present a drug Monday. It's been on my mind for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
I've been trying to reduce
that. Yeah, you don't have to.
Monday, when I'm done, I'll do my typing for you.
Yeah, you don't have to put that on PowerPoint, you know, testimony. Just send it as an email. So thank you in advance, Erlina. Thank you in advance. Sure. And thank you for sharing that wonderful story with us.
Beautiful, yeah.
Yes. Anybody else would like to give a testimony?
Anybody else? Bob, since no one else is jumping forward, I'll share the symbolism on Our Lady of Guadalupe on the tilma is so powerful. I had a lady in my store 2 days ago who was an actress, and occasionally I have some in Santa Fe's of Film Town, and she had a little yin-yang ring, and you know, she's just walking around. We're talking a little bit about protection. And she walks around the store and she asked about what image that was. And I shared with her the symbolism of the sun and the moon. And this woman is something about her is greater than that, but it's not her, what she's bringing forth, which is Jesus. And I showed the symbolism. She's so intrigued by the image of Our Lady of Guadalupe. It's just a very powerful image. And, you know, she came not as a Spaniard, but she came as either a Native American or a mestizo, which is partially Hispanic, partially Native. And she was so touched, and I know she'll be back and wants to learn more. And she ended up asking about St. Michael too. So there are doors to share the Lord with people. I'm just excited about sharing the Lord at this time, which is so dark. It's a dark time, and it's a time when the little light we have will shine brighter, and the needs are so great right now. By the way, it's raining outside and this is my umbrella. I sometimes go to intercessory prayer with my umbrella because my faith isn't very weak if I don't take my umbrella with me. So I take my umbrella. Gosh, you can't even see it, but that shows that I'm expecting it to rain and it's raining outside. So thank you, Lord.
Yes. Yeah, we will pray. And now we will pray for healing.
Amen.
Okay? Because the Lord is the healer.
Yes.
In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. And Lord, we thank you. We praise you. We glorify your name.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Lord, because you are healing us. And Lord, you are the healer. You are the Lord. You are the King. And you know our situations physically, emotionally, mentally, financially, spiritually, physically. You know everything, Lord. And Lord, we believe that your will is for us to be well, to be healed, to be whole.
Amen.
Lord, we ask you right now to release your healing grace and your healing touch. Lord, look not on our sins, but on our desire, oh Lord, to be well and to be with you and to be touched by you in a very special way.
Yes,
Lord, because as you said in your words, that you love us with an everlasting love.
That's right.
That nothing can separate us from your love. Mm. Nothing at all. Not sin, nor height, nor death, nor anything at all can separate us from your love. And Lord, we ask you right now to let that healing grace flow unto us and to our entire being and heal us, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And let your ministering angels, St. Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael, to minister to us in Jesus' name. And we ask Mary, our mother, the mother of God, the mother of the Messiah, the mother of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Blessed Virgin Mary, to intercede and to pray for us. Mother, your mantle of healing
be
on us.
Yes.
And we ask St. Joseph, the husband of Mary, the terror of demons, to intercede for us in the mighty name and the blood of Jesus. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, the Comforter. Come, Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Come, Holy Spirit, the power, the uncreated power of God, to saturate us with that same power that raised Lazarus from the tomb, oh Lord. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. It's your precious blood. And Lord, we ask you that you continue, Lord, to use us in a mighty way. Continue to anoint us and empower us. And we command you, foul spirit of infirmity, spirit of heaviness and bondage, is all curses, hexes, spells, witchcraft, black magic, demonic assignments, manifest, maledictions, and the evil eye, diabolic infestations, oppressions, positions, all that is evil and sinful, jealousy, treachery, envy, all physical, psychological, moral, spiritual, and diabolical ailments, be gone from us and our family members and go to the foot of the cross to be disposed of by Jesus. And in Jesus' name, we speak of tremendous blessings, peace, joy, love, light, and life, long longevity, long lifespan, victory, joy, peace, and all graces from you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for hearing our prayers. And we seal our healings in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, through the blood of Jesus, and through the intercession of Mary, our mother, in the mighty name and the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Okay, and in the book of 2 Thessalonians, chapter 2, verses 16 to 17. Saint Paul says, may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who loved us and by his grace give us eternal encouragement and good hope, encourage your hearts and strengthen you in every good deed and word. The word from the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Lord. And
yeah.
Thank you, Brother Ben.
You're welcome.
Ben, for that beautiful song. Now, I thank everyone, especially our host, Comadre Vicky, and we got a great picture to be sold to worldwide audience. And
I'm gonna look some old ones up too, Comadre. You have it, and I can't take the credit for this awesome hosting. I was not the host ever. I mean, I came in and out.
No, please, you're on Ramon.
But it's, there you go. There he is.
Mr. Ramon, we'd like to thank you.
Yay.
Ramon, and for your able hosting, very able hosting, Ramon.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
For all the music ministry, we have Emmeline, and we have Dr. Dodong, Ben, and we have Chini, and we have RJ. We have John, and you know, those people who have been using their gifts in praying, leading us to different prayers. And we thank you, those healing teams, powerful and anointed members of the healing teams. We thank you for your sharing your gifts. Mm-hmm. You know, I could not thank enough God, I could not thank him enough for letting me associate with all of you, because you are gifted people, you love the Lord, you are all powerful people, and you are very, very cooperative. You are very you give your whole self, your whole being for God's glory and honor. And we thank you, those who give their testimonies. you know, we thank you for sharing those good news that the Lord has given you, and for sharing those good news with us. So we could not thank you enough. And of course, I'd like to remind also the members of the healing teams and the music ministry, you know, of our meeting on Tuesday. Tuesday, I think, what is that? Is that August 31st? Tuesday?
Yes.
August 31st at 5. Remember, Cinco Lima. Cinco Lima, 5 p.m. Pacific time, or 8 p.m. New Jersey time, and 8 a.m. Manila time. Okay.
Thank you, Bob.
Yes, and so please don't forget to attend that meeting, agenda meeting, and we will also evaluate our prayer meeting, and we will evaluate what went on the prayer meeting that needs to be emphasized, what are the things that we should correct or anything like that we should emphasize more or something like that, okay? And we will review this picture, beautiful picture of Comadre Vicky, how we can sell this, how we can sell this to World Wide Web, you know, because if they want to make some, you know, ask for money, this is a good backdrop, you know?
We'll lose money. Don't.
No, there's a money maker.
No.
I mean, you have, Joe, you have seen it. What do you think?
I thought it was a picture of Lot's wife. But... Because she was frozen.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So anyway, is it, Comadre, it's in the recording, right?
The recording started with when you heard it just about 5 minutes ago, because we turned it all off. And you
why did you turn it off?
Because you asked me to turn it off, and we always cut off all of the prayer requests.
All right.
The song, so.
Okay, please, as I said, please watch our video. It will be available 24 hours later, or sometimes earlier than that. Okay, earlier than that. So please access them. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And so, again, we will see you, God willing. On Tuesday, for some of you, we'll see you on Tuesday. And for the rest of you, God willing, we'll see you on next Saturday. And invite people to come. Tell them you have nothing to lose but your illness.
Amen.
Tell them that. You have nothing to lose but your illness. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. By the way, Alex, I hope you can come on Tuesday also.
I didn't get a chance to ask for a prayer for a blessing. Because tomorrow on Sunday at noon, I'm praying for this young boy. Mm-hmm. He has the lymphoma cancer. And so I'm going to be praying for him tomorrow at the church. And I just wanted a blessing from you guys that the Holy Spirit will give me the words to say for his miracle healing.
Okay, I'd like to ask Brother Ramon to lead that prayer. Of blessing. Brother Ramon, our host.
He's asleep. Oh no, there he is.
There he is. Okay.
Don't be a Bob.
Blessing prayer.
Yeah.
What prayer, Bob?
Oh. Prayer for Alex to be, as he ministers tomorrow, that the Lord will use him in a powerful way and that protect him. Okay? Go ahead.
In the name of Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord God, our Father in heaven, through and in the name of Jesus Christ, we ask for your anointing upon Alex as he will minister tomorrow, Sunday, that he will minister and carrying your graces, carrying your peace, carrying your healing and carrying your joy to the person that persons that he will minister to. Lord, we know that if only us will do these things, nothing will prosper. But if through your power and your knowing the thing that you will make things possible.
Amen.
And that your plans will be put to place and will unfold in the lives of those that will be ministered tomorrow and that of Alex. And Father, we thank you for this gift of anointing on Alex, and that powerful graces will come forth in tomorrow's session. Father, we pray this in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Ramon.
Thank you.
Now, is Pacquiao back already in the Philippines?
Oh, my word. Compadre.
Huh?
I love you. I got to go.
Bye, everybody. God bless.
He's healing, healing, physically healing.
Physical healing? He's there?
Yeah, in California.
He's still in California, huh? He's still in LA.
Yeah. He doesn't want to be seen with Puff.